All right, guys.
Got to do code number two here. Got to shake it up.
Steal you over here for a second. Got a little bit touch up on this guy. Okay, I can do the lid now again a little bit. I'm just doing a light coat on that one. I'll do the back side of that later. Let's see what we got here. The back of the barrel is not bad, actually. Trailer run? Alrighty. Okay. Looks like this stuff doesn't really stick on the second coat, does it? I'm not gonna do the inside because it says it'll cook right off of if the flame is directly on the surface, it's just gonna cook it off. So not gonna happen there. I might hold on to the can for a little bit, shoot it upside down, get rid of the air, and then come back later and hit it again maybe. But it's been a few hours, so I think we're good, if you ask me. You know what I mean? I think you know what I mean. Well, actually, what I'll do is I'll flip up the... Should I do the back lid of that kit? Probably not. Because that will be inside the fire. So, yeah, there's no point in me doing that. Yeah, that gasket seemed to work pretty good. Not too shabby. So we'll see how this makes out. I'll have to come back out later, guys, and spray some more, it looks like. So I'm gonna drop the stove back over carefully. And I might do the back end just for the shits and giggles here. That way it has a nice air dry surface. Shoot the back a little bit maybe. And then that'll be all she wrote. This says little pinholes. This is damn good paint, man. It's expensive, but worth it. Get a little bit around the edge too. Ooh, that knocked some shit off of there. See that? Not good. I'll come back later though and touch this sucker up. Let this sucker air dry some more. A couple more hours.